Let me start today another topic, that is data types in Java. Normal, how you are going to be using normal data types, normally in the data types in other programming language, say for example in C, the same style in the Java also. Let me have say that what type of data you are going to be assigning for a variable, that type of the data is going to be representing with the help of data type. In simply, you are assigning some value to a variable. What type of variable, what type of value you are assigned to that variable is specifying that data type. Now you are saying int a equal to 10. Now you 10 you are going to assign. What is the type of a? How you can be say with the help of that representing what type of value you are assigning for a variable is called as data type. Type of the data representing type of the data is called as data type. Representing type of the data is called as data type. In simpler terms, data type represents the different values to be stored in the variable. In Java, we are having two types of data types. One is primitive, another is non-primitive. Let me see a graphically the entire the data type concepts. Clearly observe this figure. And see here, in this figure, we are going to talking about data type consisting of two types, primitive, non-primitive. Again, primitive is dividing into two types. One is Boolean and there is numeric. Again, a Boolean is representing with only one word, that is, this is Boolean data type. Again, numeric data type consisting of two types, character, integral. Character data type can be represented with char. Again, integral data type divided into two types. One is integer and there is floating point. Integer data types are representing with byte data type, short data type, int data type, long data type. Whereas floating point data types represent with float data type, double data type. Coming to the second data type, non-primitive, such as string, array, list, non-linear data structures all comes under non-primitive. Okay, I repeat, data types are two types. One is primitive, another is non-primitive. Primitive, again, it's divided into two types, Boolean and numeric. Boolean data type can be represented with Boolean keyword. Again, numeric data type consisting of two types, divided into two types, character, integral. Character data type will be represented with char keyword in Java. Integral data type, again, it is divided into two types. One is integer, another is floating point number. Now, this again, this integral will be divided into integer and floating point number. Now, this will be talks about integer data types can be represented with the keywords called byte, short, int, long. Floating point data types will be represented with float, double. And string arrays will be have a, as usual, we have the topics. There we'll discuss about this non-primitive data types. Let me have discuss in detail about each one. Fine. Let me see the sizes of each and every data type here. Let me talk whatever the data types. If you are observe carefully in this one, in the last of the line, last of this line in the figure, these are the 8 different data types we are going to be using in Java. Mainly, these are the 8 different data types you are going to be using. Not only this 8, and also we have the string array, also that other data types are there. But probably the primitive data types, or these are 8 primitive data types we are going to be using in Java. Boolean, char, byte, short, int, long, float, double. Let me have discuss their sizes, their default values, how they are going to be representing now. So in this table, it is clearly mentioning that how we are going to be representing the each data default data values and what are the sizes. The first column talks about the data type. Second column talks about the default value. Third column talks about the default size. Let me start with Boolean. Boolean is a data type. the default value for the boolean is false and the size of the boolean is consisting of 1 bit. Now second data type, char. The default value is, you are going to be storing, this is the default value, this is we are going to mentioning slash 0U0000, which is in single quote. The data type size here is 2 bytes, whereas in C it is a 1 byte. Now coming to the third data type, byte. Normally byte equal to 8 bits, so the default value is 0 and it consisting of the size is 1 byte. Now short, this short default value is 0 and the size of the short is 2 bytes. Next data type is integer. The default value is 0 and the size of this integer is 4 bytes, whereas in C the data size of the integer data type is 2 bytes. Next is long. The default value is 0L, where L indicates long, and the size is 8 bytes. Next is float. The default value is 0.0F, where F indicates float, and the size is 4 bytes. Double, next data type, is a 0.0D, where D indicates double. The size is 8 bytes. If you observe carefully here, for the short int double, these are for the short, that is an integer, it is a 4 byte. Off of that one, off of the integer, that is a short, is 2 bytes. Double of the integer is long, that is 8 bytes. So for integer is a 4 bytes, for short is a 2 bytes, for long it is a 8 bytes. And if you observe carefully, the default values for byte, short, integer is 0, and the default values for the long, float, double is also be 0, but representing long with capital L, representing float value both the decimal and fraction with 0.0F, and representing the double, again it's consisting of decimal as well as fraction, so that's why we are representing with 0.0D. And these are the different sizes. Whatever we are going to using in C, that the maximum double of the sizes will be there in Java. So these are the 8 different data types and their the default values and the default sizes. Let me have discuss in detail about with small sort of example here. Let me have a small program which can talks about this data types. We are not covering all the data types, but only for better understanding how it will be done, it will let me see. I am creating a class called as simple and we are calling a function called as main. Now I assign int a equal to 10. This is called as initialization. Int b equal to 10. This is also be called as initialization. Int c equal to a plus b. This is also called as initialization. Now we are assigning a lower value to a higher data type. It will be acceptable. When you are assigning a higher value to a lower one, then it's not acceptable. Now f equal to a. Now what is the a value actually? 10. Now for this 10, what will be done is, for this 10, it will be done as, when you are assigning a value 10, in f it will be there 10.0f. It will be automatically assigned as 10.0f. When you consider the case here, this is f equal to again 10.5f. It is assigning. Now it is going to be assigning 10.5f. Now when you see here in this one, in the compilation here, when you are observe carefully in this one, it is showing in this part. Int a equal to f. What is there in f? 10.5f will be there. So 10.5f, when you want to be directly assigning a bigger one to the smaller one, when you are assigning a floating value to a integer value, lower value, higher value, lower value, it raises the compile time error. To overcome the problem, we are going to using the concept called as type conversion, which is the next topic in our thing. Now this line is called as type conversion. This is called as type conversion. Now how we are going to mentioning the type conversion is, let me see roughly a small syntax. So we are representing as data type to which we want to be convert, var one, this is var one variable, and inside the parentheses, at the right hand side, inside the parentheses, in which format this var two variable want to convert, that we have to mention in the parentheses. And this right hand side, after conversion, to which data type you want to assign, that has to represent in left hand side. I repeat, var2 indicates the variable which you want to be converted. In which data type you want to convert, you have to mention in parentheses. And inside the parentheses, you have to mention the data type. This is at right hand side. This is conversion has done. Once the conversion has done the respective variable, now you need to assign to a particular variable, right? To which variable of which type you want to assign, that has to mention at the left hand side. So this is called as conversion of a variable into the respective variable. This var2 is one data type variable that is again converting into another type of data type value. So this is the right hand side. Left hand side, once this conversion has done, to whom, which variable of which type you want to be assigned, that has to mention in the left hand side. This is about the type conversion. We'll discuss in detail about in the next topic, no need to worry. And the last statement, we are going to be displaying the information. Just in the last statement, we are going to be display C. Now in this example, we have seen how to initialize a data type of int, how to initialize a data type of float, how to assign a float value, how to assign an integer value to a float, and how to we can assign a float value by type conversion to an integer value. So C equal to A plus B, the output of this program is 20 will be there. Because at this line of point, when this line of statement is encountered, the C value, that is E equal to A plus B, A value is 10 and B value is 20. That's why the value of C is 20 will be there. A value is 10, B value is 10, 10 plus 10, 20 will be assigned to this. Okay. Now let me see their sizes of each data type. Let me talk about their sizes. Firstly, we'll start with byte data type. We have totally 8 data types are there, right? So firstly, each one after the other, we'll talk about now here. Now let me see. We'll go for first byte. So see, byte is nothing but 8 bits as usual. So byte is nothing but 8 bits will be there. 8 bit assigned, the assigned 2's complement integer. The range of this one is 2 power of 8 means we are going to taking as the, it is has to take from the 0 to 7. 8 means how we are representing 0 to 7. It is representing. That's why the range is, if you are unable to remember the value, please remember as in the power of 2 minus 2 power of 7 to plus 2 power of 7 minus 1. That is minus 128 to plus 127. The default value already we had discussed in the table, that is 0, right? So why we are going to using this byte is, if you are going to using instead of integer, it has to take 4 bytes. If you know already you are going to using a variable of size only 8 bit up to the size of minus 2 power of 7 between the two plus 2 power of 7 minus 1, then you can better to go for instead of roughly can declare as a int A, you can declare as byte A, so that you can save the space in the larger arrays values. Okay. The second type of the data type here we are going to talk as short. In this short, that is a 2 bytes. So 2 bytes is converted as into bits means 16 bit signed at 2's complement integer. Now the ranges here is normally the integer. Normally in the C, the integer range is minus 3 to 7, 6, 8 to plus 3 to 7, 6, 7. Now simply if you want to remember in the ranges, minus 2 power of 15 to plus 2 power of 15 minus 1. So the default value for short is 0, right? Let me see the next data type. Only have to please try to remember the size followed by the range followed by the default value. Why we are going to using that? Not more than that is required. Next is integer. It is a 4 byte actually. So 4 byte equal to in the form of bits is a 32 bit. The ranges is the minus 2 power of 31 to plus 2 power of 31 minus 1. So the default value for integer is 0. Okay. You can have a small example also. Or else for all data types, you can have a writable C program. Next data type you are going to be talking about the long, where long talks about is a 8 byte. So 8 byte equal to, if you are converting into a bits, it's a 16 bit sine 2's complement. The ranges is minus 2 power of 63 to plus 2 power of 63 minus 1. The default value, as I said you, 0 L. L stands for long value. We can consider that. And the next data type we are going to be talking about is float. The float value, it is consisting of 4 bytes. So 4 bytes is nothing but is a 32 bit floating point, where it is having a single precision. Single precision is consisting of both decimal and the fraction part. Now mainly we are going to focus on to save the memory in larger of floating point numbers. The default value for float is 0.0f. Like this we can have a small example. Let me have see the next data type in this one. next data type, double. So double consisting of actually 8 bytes. So 8 bytes in the sense, it is in the form of bits is 64 bit. Now, what is the difference between float and double means? Float is a single precision, whereas double is a double precision. Double precision means after the dot, it will be considered as the maximum values of the float is 6, and it is going to be considering double of that one. Say for example, if the float is consisting after the dot, like 23.5 means it is in the float 23.5, after that is a 5 zeros. Totally after the dot, it is a fraction values, maybe 6 digits, for example. If it is considered as that one, now after the dot in double, it is taking as a double precision, double taking of the double of the fraction. That is 12 values up to it will be considered. So the default value of the default value of this one is 0.0D, where D stands for double. Like this also, we can mention a small example. The next one has Boolean. So Boolean is going to talking as a true or false. So simply it is. It's a one bit, not also byte also. It's a one bit to store 0 or 1. It's only 1 byte is enough. So the default value is false. We can use like Boolean 1 = 2. Like this is the declaration we can done. This is an initialization. For every data type, the last line what we have shown is a initialization of that data type. How you are going to using that variable. You are going to using that data type inside that. And the next data type we are going to talking, that is char. So in the char, we are going to talking about, it is going to for storing the character, single characters values. Now the size is actually, it is a 2 bytes. 2 bytes means it's a single 16-bit Unicode. It's a 16-bit of the code you are going to be calling, 16-bit Unicode character. The default value here we are going to be talking about is the /U0000. And here we are going to assign like char a variable equal to the characters. Like in a single quote, we can assign capital A, small a, capital B, anything we can assign, but we have to assign as in a single quote, single character, single quote. We have to assign that as a data type for this one. Okay. So the data types for all the data types, whatever we have seen, the total data types we have seen over here, each data type, what we have explained is, in this concept, we have seen the different data types. One is the primitive, another is a non-primitive, clearly mentioning what primitive, again, how it is categorized. Finally, all the 8 data types, how it mentioning with their type, value, and default sizes of each data type, followed by a small example we have seen, and followed by for every data type, we have seen actual size, the range, the default value, and how they are going to be initialized. So for every data type, I have shown you the size, the range, the default value, and one small example for every data type in the size, the range, the default value, and initialization. Long, the range, the size, and the default value, and an example. Example means initialization of the float, the range here, and the size, default value, an example. In similar fashion, double, as well as Boolean, as well as character. So that's about the data types in Java.